And I just want to come and give you a quick encouragement and some practical tips on how to not allow limiting beliefs to keep you from making forward momentum on your dreams. So I'm Brenda Bertrand, and I just wrote a blog post for Forward Women, and you can see the link here below. But I said, and I say it all the time to my clients, my friends, and to my own soul, that you are one belief away from living the life that God has called you to. And the reason why I say that is because I know in my own life, I don't know about you, but the minute I decide to follow a dream or to take inspired action on something that I've been thinking about for a long time, the first thing that happens is there's a voice in my head, and she may live in your head as well, that says, you're not ready. You can't do this. You're not ready. You don't have what it takes. You're not enough. And that may come in a million different ways to you, and you may hear that voice in different ways. And I want to encourage you right now that those beliefs keep us, keeps me, keeps you from moving toward what God has called us to do. And there are three simple ways in which we can actually move past those beliefs and replace them with more empowering beliefs that can get us into action. You ready? All right, let's go. So first, I want you to notice that belief. I want you to name it. Like I told you, for me, it shows up as, you're not ready. Don't do this. Other people are doing this. What will they think? So the first thing to do is to notice the thought and to be aware of it. Take responsibility that I have been thinking, we have been thinking, you have been thinking the same thought over and over that has not gotten any good results. So you notice the thought and you name it. And in naming it, you ground yourself in the hope that God has something more for us and that there is something that will give us greater results than the thought that we're thinking. Because that belief doesn't get you anywhere except into sadness. It's actually a violent and hurtful thought. It's a painful thought. The second thing after you've noticed the thought is that you tend to the part of your soul that has really needs healing or needs grace or forgiveness or peace or direction. Because really those limiting beliefs, it's just our brain trying to keep us safe. But at the end of the day, if I hear over and over, Brenda, you are not enough, that's violence upon myself. And I want to tend to the parts of me that does feel inadequate, the parts of me that doubts my value, the parts of me that feel that I don't have what it takes. And so that may look like just repenting, or it may look like asking God to be present to the parts of me that feel inadequate. It may be saying and interrogating that thought and saying, you know, it's not true. I have made a difference in the past. I have taken inspired action in the past. I do not feel confident today, but I do have what it takes. So tending to that part is an important next step. The last thing is now we want to really move into a new belief system. And this is a long process and a lifelong process. But what would it look like instead of rehearsing over and over, I'm not good enough, I don't have what it takes, we actually start to move into those things that it says in Philippians, to focus on the things that are lovely and true and authentic and are of a good report, the things that God would agree with about me, which says, today I'm doing my best, or this dream is worthy of my attention, instead of I don't have what it takes and I can't do that, what will they think? So I want to encourage you today, you are one belief away from walking in the calling that God has called you to. And during these turbulent, chaotic, uncertain times where our hope is exhausted and we're concerned about what's possible, having a belief that can agree with what God says about you is probably the most healing and loving thing we can do. So notice the thought that's disempowering. Tend to the parts of your soul that really feels inadequate. And then start to say, just today, a thought and a belief, the one belief that will lead you in the direction of agreeing with God, what God says is true about you. Friends, you are enough, you've done enough, you're adequate, and the thing that's calling you is worthy of your attention, and God is in full support of you. Let us know how we can support you. I'm Brenda Bertrand, and I'm so grateful for your presence in the world, and I will see you very, very soon.